ونستعين به ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، أرسل رسوله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره المشركون. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقائدنا ومرشدنا وحجتنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وصحبه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة. عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله وطاعته، وأحثكم على التمسك بهدي قرآنه وسنة نبيه. فقد قال الله جل من قائل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. صدق الله العظيم. Dear brothers and sisters, following up on last week's theme that we discussed, and we talked about huzn and hazan and sadness and depression in face of what is happening in the world today, you probably noticed, if like everybody following what is happening on social media, that theories and worries are intensifying about what's going to be the shape of the world in a week's time. When we wake up the morning of the 21st of January, how will the world look like? And people continue to worry. I hope not those who heard the message. And I'd like to elaborate on that concept of worry. Now, put depression and sadness and sorrow aside. I'm not going to talk anymore about that because we talked about it. But I would like to talk about a divine law. You remember a few weeks back, maybe 3 or 4 months back, I talked about divine laws. That there are laws that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to us that are more factual and more immutable than the laws of physics and chemistry and biology. The law that governs how we should really react to the uncertainty or certainties that we encounter in the world today, we don't know what is happening. Our Islam, as per a divine law in the Quran, tells us, as we read in Surah At-Tawbah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Remember, it's a law. It doesn't change. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. This is the law. And a little bit of analysis after I translate or attempt to translate, say, O Muhammad, tell believers that never, never will anything happen to us except that which Allah had decreed. Nothing. Now, here I would like to compare لن with لا. Imagine if the ayah or part of the ayah read قل لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا. قل لا يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا. But it reads قل لن يصيبنا إلا ما كتب الله لنا. لن as opposed to لا means in Arabic تأبيد النفي. تأبيد النفي يعني it is not a negation, it's a permanent negation, it will never happen. But when you say لا يصيبنا, it means one time it may not happen to us, another time it may. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us لن يصيبنا. We will never be struck with anything save that which Allah decreed for us. And look at this again, another comparison. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. لَنَا is different than عَلَيْنَا. If we read قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا, immediately we will understand that which will happen to us as a punishment. عَلَيْنَا. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. Because quite often things that happen to us are in our favor, but we don't realize the benefits behind things that appear disastrous, when in fact they are that which is the real good that we were waiting. وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Many of the things that we don't like. It could be that the best thing will happen to Muslims is Donald Trump. It doesn't matter what will happen, what he will do, it may be the best thing, because we really need to wake up. Because we are in a state of unconsciousness, we are fainting. And to bring a person back from a state of fainting, you need to do that. Not to hurt the person who's fainted, but to really excite, as I said it before, those nerve endings and send a message to the central nervous system, wake up. So things that we are afraid of, let us deal with under that. I don't want to say slogan, because slogans are many. الشعارات كثيرة ولكن العمل قليل. There are many slogans, but action is little. We need to act. We need to act as per nothing, absolutely nothing. We should feel peaceful. We should feel peaceful. And here I would like now to go to something about a difference again. Again, let us look at the difference between peace on one hand and safety and security on the other. Is peace, safety and security are one and the same? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. As-salama means safety and security. Peace means amn. Amn. People may be safe and secure for a year. Nothing happened to them. Absolutely nothing. They were safe and secure. But were they peaceful during that year? They may not. Because if people were always looking over their shoulder and very worried and unsettled and disturbed, a year may pass with nothing of what they were fearing would happen to them. Nothing happened to them. But during that year, where nothing happened to them, They made themselves lose sleep. They did not have, as they say in English, they did not have peace of mind. They were secure, but they did not have peace because they did it to themselves. Because they did not really live as per, nothing may befall us save that which Allah had decreed for us, absolutely nothing. فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ Ya Allah, everything in the Quran is a treasure. Look in Surah Al-An'am, Ayat 81 and 82. Go and study them. Go and study them. فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون. Back again to Iman and faith. Do you remember what Abu Sa'id al-Hasan al-Basri, when asked, are you a believer? Remember last week? And he immediately said about the ayat of Surah Al-Anfal, about the true faith. Whenever Allah is mentioned, they tremble. Their hearts tremble, not out of fear, but out of expectation, out of love. This is what faith is all about. And a faithful person is a person that feels security. Allah is asking us a question in Surah Al-An'am. Who do you think is more worthy of feeling peace, not feeling security? Feeling peace. Allah answers the question that He asks us, and He says, "Alladheena aman." Not only that, وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ. Their iman is pure, is transparent. Their iman is clear. Their iman is direct with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No pretense, nothing. It's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنِ. These people indeed will feel the peace. Look, feeling peace has a price. Don't always, you know, be on the edge of your seat. Again, I was told it's PD day. And that means that children have a right. Even though you will say, again, you told us, you know, a fairy tale from storybooks. Last week, I will tell it again this week. Not the same story, another story. Which will pour into the same river. The river of what worries, what disturbances may do to us. Children, listen to me. Adults, you can listen as well. A mouse sat in front of a lion. And the mouse looked at the lion and he said, please, give me security this time. Give me security. Allow me to continue what I want to say until I'm done. So the lion said to the mouse, you're secure. I won't do anything to you. Say what you want to say. The mouse looked at the lion and he said, would you believe me that I can, the mouse, kill you, the lion, within a month? The lion smiled at the mouse and said, okay, but if you don't kill me, and he was so sure, if you do not kill me after this month, I'm going to kill you. The mouse said, okay, I accept that. I accept that. Now, the first week passed, and the lion started to see dreams that indeed the mouse was killing him, and he was feeling a little uncomfortable. The second week, he started to feel, what if the mouse has a plan? What if the mouse will really kill me? What would happen? The third week, the lion was starting to feel really uneasy, and he started to feel terrified that there may be something, because this mouse would not say what he said to me unless he had a plan. The fourth week, the lion was in a state of panic. And when the month passed, the mouse and many furious animals entered the place where the lion was, and they found the lion a dead body. The lion was dead. And why did that happen? Because the entire month, the lion was living with the fear that the calamity will befall him. He will indeed be killed by the mouse, even though it is impossible. But the lion was living in a state of fear. And here the lesson that we really need to learn is that if we do not have true faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we live our lives feeling that tomorrow this will happen, and this will happen, and this will happen, indeed it will happen to us. Because as, you know, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him a long life, Shaykh Muhammad Rafi bin Nawusi said something very interesting. He said that الخوف من وقوع المصيبة مصيبة بحد ذاتها والخوف من الفقر يجر إلى الفقر والخوف من المرض مرض في نفسه. He said that fearing a calamity will bring that calamity upon you, and fearing poverty will make you live in a state of poverty. And feeling that illness is going to come to you will make you indeed ill. How often did we say, oh, something is wrong with my heart? And then what would happen? Our heart will start to race. We will start to hyperventilate. We will start to feel, oh, I'm feeling pain in my arm. Yes, indeed, something is wrong. Yes, and the more you think about it, the more your heart will race, and indeed, you will go, and then they will do an ECG and this, and they say, well, yes, your blood pressure has reached this level. You brought it upon yourself. And I'm not saying there are cases when this is a problem, as I said last week. But when you really start to worry, because قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا, you will never be ill unless Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had decreed that you will become ill. So don't worry. Don't worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring, you know, goodness upon you. Look at this. You know, I don't have much time because I really have to go to the London Muslim Mosque to repeat what I'm saying here. So I want to finish, inshallah, in the second khutbah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فيا فوز المستغفرين. Make dua for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and accept our dua. Amen. Ya Rabbal Alameen. الحمد لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. Now, just a thought, I will expand upon this in another khutbah, inshallah. But look at this, there is a surah that was revealed very early on. Actually, it was revealed, as some of the scholars of Quran say, next to Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, the first revelation. Because revelation, you know, stopped for some time, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam felt bad. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to him a surah that most of the children, most of the adults, know that surah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى. I will stop here. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making an oath, and he is telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah did not abandon you. Allah has reasons for everything, and Allah has better things for you than what happened to you in the beginning. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Some people understand this as the hereafter will be better for you than this dunya. But the majority of the mufassireen of the Quran, they said, no, the meaning is bigger than that. That ends of things are more agreeable than the beginning. So if things cease, if revelation ceased in the beginning, what is happening after is going to be better. Because had it been the hereafter is better than this life, it could have been وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. But it said وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. From the, you know, and let us go back all the way to the revelation of Surah Al-Duha. Now look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what's coming is better than what passed. You know what came after this surah? What came after this surah was the siege for 3 years in Sha'b Abi Talib. When the family, Banu Hashim, they died of thirst and hunger, 3 years. Is this better than what happened before? What happened after that is the torture that many of the companions of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ were subjected to. Many things that, and one would say, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then say that what is happening afterwards is better than what passed? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to see things with a bigger lens. If we will stop at every cold and every flu and every little disturbance, we will not see the bigger picture. You know, every time you get the flu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may be saving you from a more serious illness because of the antibodies that were made in your body as a result of that flu that you recovered from. You didn't like it, but it's good for you. Things that you may not like, the things that are happening around us, they may bring that which is better than what we are going through now. Now imagine, and with this I will end, imagine if when we had the previous prime minister, we thought that we want to leave Canada only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us a prime minister that appointed a Muslim as the new minister of immigration. Would this have been thought of at the time of the previous prime minister when we felt that this is it? And the same thing we are thinking now, that south of the border is now being brewed, or being, you know, that the plan is being made to eliminate Muslims. Please don't ever forget, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. Always be hopeful. قُلْ لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وخطايانا وإسرافنا في أمرنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم علمنا من ديننا ما جهلنا، وذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وكن معنا ولا تكن علينا. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم، ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله.